सेल स्ट्रक्चर एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ओके सो इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट व्हाट ऑल द स्ट्रक्चर्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द प्लांट और ईदर द एनिमल सेल. ओके और यू कैन कंसिडर देम एज व्हाट प्रोकैरियोट एज वेल एज यूकैरियोट एज वेल एज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ द सेम हाउ दे आर ऑर्गेनाइज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल when we consider cells, now we all know that any living organisms, if we take, they will be having what, or they will be made up of what? Cells. So living things are made of cells. So there are typical cells, like for example, you can categorize them as animal cell, plant cell, prokaryotic cell or eukaryotic cell, correct? So different types you can classify them as. So first of all, there are some important organelles which are present in a typical cell. Okay, so if I consider a typical cell or a common cell, okay, there are certain organelles which are very important. For example, first one is cell membrane. So cell membrane, okay, after the cell wall, whatever the membrane which you have is called as what? Cell membrane. So the property of the cell membrane is basically they are either, or you can say regarding its permeability, means to allow the substance to come in as well as go out. Okay, it can be of two types. First one is either it can be partially permeable. Or differentially permeable, you can say. So with this characteristic only, it will allow what? Certain substances to enter and leave the cell. Second is cytoplasm. Now, cytoplasm is nothing but a liquid medium which is contained in a cell, and this is a place wherein all the chemical reaction will take place. Third one is nucleus. Also known as the brain of the cell. So nucleus is the thing, it's called as brain because it contains what? The major genetic material which is going to control the entire processes which will take place inside a cell. So basically it contains what? DNA, which will help in controlling the cell. Fourth important organelle is mitochondria. Okay, now mitochondria basically known as what? The powerhouse of the cell. So all the aerobic respiration which is there, it basically takes place inside this mitochondria. Okay, so if I consider a particular, say, animal cell, it will be having these organelles for sure. Okay, a typical animal cell will be having what? All these kinds of organelles, because these four organelles are very important for a cell to function. Now, on the other hand, if I consider the plant cells, suppose. Okay, so if I am considering plant cells, there will be a certain difference in the presence of the organelles. For example, as we all know that plant cells, what they do is they prepare their own food. That is because of the presence of what? Chloroplast and the process of photosynthesis, which they do. So therefore, there are some organelles which are responsible for making this what? Plant cell differ from the animal cell. So one such organelle is the vacuole. Okay, so the main important function of the vacuole is what? Storage. Means it stores food as well as water. And hence it also helps in maintaining what? Shape of the cell. Second is the cell wall. Now, cell wall's major function is, along with the protection, it will give what? Rigidity to the cell. So that it can maintain the shape again. And the third one, which is very important, is the chloroplast. Now, chloroplast are the structures which contains what? Chlorophyll. Okay, and this chlorophyll is going to absorb the light which is required for photosynthesis. So this is how you can differ the plant cell and animal cell on the basis of cell organelles, okay, how they are arranged in that particular thing. So, considering this only, there are what different levels of organization. Like for example, you can take, there are some specialized cells, okay, which will carry out what? Certain functions. So, let's see what are those specialized cells. Okay, so specialized cells. So some important special cells which you will find in animal as well as plant cells are as follows. Okay, so first one is red blood cells. That is RBCs. So the major function of RBC is what? Oxygen transportation. Why? Because it contains a pigment called as hemoglobin, which helps in carrying the oxygen throughout the body. So if you see the major structure of the RBC, okay, it's basically biconcave in shape, you can say, with no nucleus. So why it doesn't have a nucleus is because, as I told you, RBC is a cell which carries oxygen. So it's very necessary that it should able to fit more amount of oxygen into it so that it can supply the same to the body. That is why it doesn't have what? Nucleus. Then it is flexible. Plus, as I already told you, it has what? Hemoglobin. Second type of cell is what? We can take the ciliated type of cell. Ciliated cell. Okay, now ciliated cell's major function is to move and push the mucus. Because ciliated cells means what? Small, tiny cilia will be present. And what is cilia? Cilia is nothing but tiny hairs. Then comes the another type of cell, which is muscle cell. Very important whenever there is a contraction needed. Okay. So basically muscle cell, what it does is it contracts so that whatever structures are there, they get closer together and perform the function. So hence, this muscle cell, as compared to the rest of the cells, animal cells, will be what? Long. With plenty of protein fibers. Okay, but whenever this muscle cell will contain energy, okay, whenever the energy is available, what happens to the muscle cell is it becomes short. Okay, so that is the feature of the muscle cell. Next one is, we'll consider about some plant cells such as root hair cells. Root hair cells. So root hair cells means what? Root hair means obviously the basic function will be what? Absorbs the water. Absorbs water. Plus some minerals from the soil. Hence, whatever the root hair cells is there, they will be elongated in shape. And they will be like having more surface area so that more absorption could be done. Next cell in the plants we can consider is xylem vessel. So xylem deals with the transport of water. Plus it acts as a support also, means it provides support to the plant as well by forming the xylem vessels. And the feature of the xylem vessel is what? It will have no cytoplasm. So because it doesn't have this cytoplasm, what will happen is the water can move freely through these vessels. Plus, you will find no cross walls in it. So because there is no cross wall, the connection between each of the vessels is very easy and it will form what? Tube. And in order to make the xylem vessel more strong, there is presence of a component which is called as lignin, which makes what? The xylem more stronger as well as waterproof. Next type of cell is palisade cells. Okay, so palisade cells means it deals mainly with the process of photosynthesis. So hence these cells are regular in shape. They'll be having a regular shape so that they can fit into even the tiniest place. And because they help in the process of photosynthesis, obviously they'll be having what? Many chloroplasts. The next one is the level of organization. Now, level of organization is nothing but the smallest cell, okay? The journey of a smallest cell to how it forms or becomes an organelle, okay? That is called as what? Or an organ, you can say. That is called as level of organization. So in that, first of all, you have is what? Organelle. So organelle is nothing but, if I consider a cell, okay, there will be a specialized part in that particular cell which will be having its own function. For example, the best example you can take as a cell organelle is the nucleus, as I told you, because it's a brain of the cell. So hence, organelle is nothing but a specialized part of a cell which has its own function. Like you can consider either mitochondria or the nucleus as well. Second is the cell. Now cell, it's a very common thing. It is nothing but what? The structure and functional unit of life. So it's the most, smallest part of a living structure. And the main feature of the cell is what? It can operate as an independent unit. Independent unit. For example, you can take any kind of cell. Like just now I told you about the RBCs. So that's a specialized cell because it has its own function, that is to carry the oxygen. So it will do that independently. Third thing is, or the level of organization is what? Tissue. So tissue is nothing but group of cells, but with similar structures. And hence what they do is they will work together. To perform a shared function. Like we can consider over here the muscle tissue. Next one is organ. Again, organ is nothing but group of tissues. Makes up a structure called as what? Organ. So again, here this organ also, what they do is they will work together to perform specific functions. Like the best example is heart. Then comes the organ system. Organ system is nothing but group of organs which will be having related functions, and again they will also work together to perform different body functions. Like you can consider the respiratory system. And then forms the complete organism. So basically, organism means what? An individual made of organ systems which will work to keep the particular organism alive. That is humans. Next is the size of specimen. How can you calculate the size of a particular specimen, whether it is plant or animal? Okay, so it's very simple. Now here, in order to calculate this, we are going to use what? The magnification, or you can say the overall size we are going to enlarge of that particular specimen. So if I want to calculate the magnification as well as the size of the specimen, then I'll be using what? The units, which will be in millimeter. Okay, so in order to calculate the magnification, the formula is the size of drawing, or the drawing size you can say, divided by the size of specimen. So here the size of specimen means what? It will be the actual size. Okay, so it's like image upon the actual, which will be 1 by A. So this is a formula which we use basically to calculate the magnification of a particular specimen or an object, you can say. So in order to remember this, okay, you have to make a triangle. Like this. Okay. And this is according the formula, you have to just write it over here. So what are these terms here? I is nothing but the image, or you can say the size of drawing, you can say, or the drawing size. Drawing size. Then A is nothing but the actual size. And M is nothing but the magnification. Okay, so accordingly, whatever term you're asked to find out, you have to just rearrange this equation. Okay, and then you will get the answer for this. For example, we already saw about the magnification. If I want to find the magnification, the simple formula is image size upon the actual size. But if they ask you actual size, then it will be image size by magnification. And the last term, if they ask you image size to find out, then it will be magnification multiplied by actual size. Okay, so if I consider this magnification, okay, it'll have, it actually doesn't have any units. Okay, hence whatever the magnification is there, magnification have no units, you can say, or any units. Hence it is written as what? Like x10, okay, or means into 10 you can write it as, or you can consider it as into maybe 1000, okay, or 5000 or something like that. Okay, for example, if I take an animal cell, okay, and I'm asked to calculate what the actual size of that particular animal cell, then what am I going to do is consider that image of an animal cell is given as 30 mm. And whatever the magnification is there, or it's, that particular cell has been magnified by a factor, say 3000. Magnification factor is how much? Magnification factor. Consider it as 3000. So now here what is remaining is the actual size, which is nothing but A. So that I have to find out. So accordingly, I told you the formula. So we have to just use it. A, actual size is equal to I upon M. So that is animal cells, image size is already given. So I will be how much? 30 mm. Plus magnification is given 3000. So the answer you will get is 0.01 mm. So 0.01 mm, you have to again convert it into micrometer, which will be 10 micrometer. So this is how you can calculate the magnification of a particular specimen.